Hello, my friends! Today we're going to color the school of fish from the page in Lost Ocean. In a school of fish, the fishes try to reach the inside of the school to escape predators. It creates a whirlpool effect. So here is my plan. My plan is to separate the dark fish from the light fish to show the vortex effect in the school. A first color combination that I'll use is this one. It's a combination that I really like to use for fish, flowers and butterfly. I'm going to use it on several fish in different ways and I'll add white and black. Prepare your pencils, we're off! Here is another combination for dark fish. You see my little magic recipe book. Here is the color combination in blue. I use 6 colors. I can also add black on top, like I did here for the first fish. The full color combination gives this gradient. Depending on the size of the fish, you can use only certain color or the entire combination. Here you see I used only 2 colors, blue, violet and cloud blue. And here I used 4. You can really combine these blue colors in different ways to make your blue fish. I'm going to show you 1 or 2 so you can see how I combine colors on fish. I watch always my little dwarf to know which ones I should do in dark colors. So here the blue fish will be amongst the dark fish on the page. For the lantern fish here, I'll start by lighting its lantern. And then I'm going to do a simple gradient from dark to light with all the colors I showed you in the palette. Now I mix my blue violet with the ultramarine blue to have a nice deep color. I gradually fade the color toward the frontal area that I will leave lit, precisely because it's lit by the lantern. And to give a fluorescent look, it's the white that I apply on my light blue. Then, to go deeper in the whole thing, I don't hesitate to add a little bit of black in certain areas that I will then mix with my darkest blue. I like to follow the patterns that Joanna drew. You see here, she has dotted lines. I think that all the patterns that she adds on her drawings are little clues that allow us to add details to our coloring pages. And then I go over my entire color sequence to blend this black and enhance my gradient effect. Thank you. When the pupil of the eye is big enough, I try to insert a small white dot in it. And I wait until my ink is completely dry before incorporating colors again with the pencils. So much for a fish that incorporates all my colors. Little Paddy is very kind today. He stays on the outside of the sheet. For a smaller fish, I can play with two shades of blue and black and white. I love this violet blue. As the gradients always look pretty, here I choose to make one from the bottom to the top. I can't help but show you my little Paddy waiting to be petted. The fish is already pretty like that. For those who want to go a step further in the intensity of the nuances, we add black and we go back with our colors from dark to light. And there you have the tools in hand to color the dark fish in shades of violet, purple and blue. With this fish, I'll show you that we can really have fun mixing colors on fish. As it is at the edge between my dark fish and my light fish, on this one I can afford to make a half and half mix. Thank you. Then, with the gel pen Uniball Signo Blue, I create small blue dots on my green. And with the yellow gel pen, I make small yellow dots on the blue. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you back very soon in part 2. Happy colorings!